So, are you gonna grab a drink or something? We really should do this.
I might.
Well, do it. Just do it!
Just do it!
Yesterday, you said tomorrow. Make your dreams come true!
Here you go, mate. While I'm gone, I'm gonna get a drink. You can watch this one.
Helps you poop.
Do it! Just do it!
Gosh. Hello and welcome to the Gamers Just Duo podcast number 27. I surprised you again. Dude, I don't think I can do it with being like, alright, I'm gonna start now and then do it. I don't think I can do that.
Why?
I don't know. I'm so used to just surprising it on, just like flinging it on you. I don't know if I could actually
fling it on me.
Flinging it like monkeys fling poop. You know what I'm saying? He knows what I'm saying. Anyways.
Def.
Yeah, okay, thanks. As you can see, first order of business, Aaron got a new camera.
Yeah.
It's widescreen, but it still looks a lot better.
HD.
It looks a lot better than that other day when we tested it. Like, right now, it looks way better than when we tested it.
Well, I have my PS4 off, and I'm only, like, really on Skype and YouTube, so.
Yeah. Maybe that's what it was. It was using up a bunch of interwebs.
Could be. And my sister's at work, and my mom's just watching TV, so there's, like, just me on the internet. So, like,
She's not playing Swordor at 15 frames. No. That's so sad. Anyways.
You got orange juice.
So. Oh, Eric has orange juice. And this is an entertainment podcast that mostly focuses on PlayStation, Destiny, video games, superheroes, comics, TV, movies, all sorts of stuff of that ilk. That's a word. Look it up. Define ilk. Type that into Google. See what comes up. Anyways. So, yeah. I am one of your hosts, TB Stiak, but you can call me Teddy. I have along with me, I have already called him by his own name.
Yes.
Eric. You said that's so weird. And now you're just like grimacing at the camera. Oh gosh. Otherwise known as Legend PBM in all sorts of places on the internet.
Or Eric Bailey 15 on Twitter.
That is true. You should change that to Legend PBM. That's all I gotta say
that. That would make sense.
It would make a lot of sense.
I'll do it right now.
He's doing it right now. Changing your
Because I'll never do it any other time.
It's true. Changing your at on Twitter is like really easy and
really okay. How do we do this? Okay, Legend PVM. Bam,
and it's done. He is at Legend PVM on Twitter as well now. So now when
changes
I
are happening, outro, guys, you just do it.
Just do it.
Just do it.
Make your dreams come true.
I made my dream come true. You can't.
Yesterday, you said tomorrow. Dude, I don't even think we should reference or tell people what that's from.
Nope.
If you don't know what that's from, it's just...
You'll see it sometime. Yeah. If you're on the internet more than like 5 hours, you will see it.
we're just going to continue to do that. Also, we are recording this on a Monday instead of a Sunday like we normally do. We normally do it on a... I mean, normally we do it on a Sunday, but last week we did it on a Monday too. Maybe it's the new thing. Hopefully not. I prefer doing it on Sunday. But I still don't mind on Monday. So. As long as we got some free time,
better
I'm okay.
Better late than never.
Yeah, better late than never. Amen. What have you been playing, Eric? Because I have been playing actually a decent amount of stuff. More than usual. I remember, too. I like mentally took a note when I played something on Monday. I'm like, I'm going to remember this.
And I I should do the same, but you know...
Yeah, I normally forget, but this week I like made it a point to remember.
I played some Adventure Capitalist.
Well, you know, always, forever and always.
Yeah. Destiny.
Of course.
Obviously.
Obvi. As the kids are saying nowadays.
I'm trying to think if I've played anything. Oh, Agario. Freaking Agario.
Oh, that game is so fun. Dude, mine's like broken. It doesn't work anymore.
Why?
I don't know. I'm going to try it again. I tried it the other day and it didn't work. I'll give you the updates. Agar.io. Anyways, people, if you want to play Agario, literally go to your search bar on your Google Chrome if you're using anything else other than Google Chrome. Suck balls. I'm just kidding. Just switch to Google Chrome. It's very nice. Then type in agar, agar.io on the search bar and type enter. And then you're playing the game, and it's awesome. Oh, it's working now. Gotta close it, because I'll just play it all night. But, oh my gosh. You knew I wasn't looking at this screen, and you just have a knife.
It's for work.
Oh, nice. You have a knife for work?
Yeah.
Well, fancy.
It's for, like, opening boxes.
Are you a gladiator? Is that what you're glad?
No, I'm Percy Jackson.
You press this secret button down here and it turns into a Greek sword.
No, I got it, mate. Here we go.
Add that in post. Add a giant Greek sword. Yes. Yeah. Nice. It's fine. Just walking. No, I'm done. I can't go any further than that. So yeah, you played Agario. You played Adventure Capitalist. You played Destiny. You played some Guild Wars.
Yes, I did. I am level 6. Sorry? The little dudes. They're like gnomes from WoW.
Yeah.
They're like really smart, and they're technological.
Technological.
Technic. Whatever.
Yeah, I I'm just
But yeah, they're cool, and they're fun, and they have a cool storyline to them.
Yeah.
But Jared's apparently like level 17.
Dang, bro. Okay, so there's Asaru, or Asura. I think that's
how you would Asura.
Say. Asura, yeah.
Yeah.
There's Asura, Silvari, Human, Norn,
okay,
and
yeah,
Char.
Then it's Asura. Yeah.
Yep, there you go. And there you go. Fact checks on the fly, brought to you by factcheck.com. Fact. Is that a thing? I'm gonna go to that right now.
Fat check.
Nope.
What?
Nope.
I see like a measuring thing. Like, you can measure.
We should totally buy. Click here to buy factcheck.com for your website name.
Oh, a fat check. Like a check. You get a lot of money.
That's not what I was referencing. Yeah, I'll try that one now. Factcheck.com.
I just see what this one is.
What the frick? It's this little dude. There's music playing.
What?
I don't know. Don't go to factcheck.com. Go to squarespace.com and register for factcheck.com.
What?
Then you can check all sorts of facts or how
facts.
Fat people are.
Back.
You can do all sorts of stuff there. It's your dream. Make your dreams come true. Anyway, you played Guild Wars, you played Agario, you play Destiny, you play one other thing that I can't remember. And Adventure Capitalist. Is that it? Sounds probably
Guild Wars,
about it.
If you didn't say that already.
Yeah, Guild Wars 2. Not the original Guild Wars.
Pretty much. Why does it keep saying my camera goes off and on?
It's fine for me.
I know it only froze for a second and like light off for like a split second. So whatever, stop.
Make your dreams come true, camera. Just do it. Gosh dang it. Yeah. So I guess that's it for Eric. That sounds about it. Sounds like it's it. So I have been playing The Unfinished Swan, which is really good. That game is awesome. Yeah. I played that.
I beat it too.
Eric played that. So. Over the years, I have heard of many PlayStation games that are very artsy and are like, oh, must plays. So this is the list of stuff that I've heard of for a while. Hohokam, Sound Shapes, Flower, Journey, and The Unfinished Swan. Out of all of those, I would recommend 3. Sound Shapes is great, but it's not a must-play. Like, it's kind of its own thing.
Yeah.
It's a platformer. It's not like play it, you'll love it. Like, not everyone will like that game because it's a platformer. And it's a really hard platformer. It's a rhythm-based platformer, which is very cool. I like Sound Shapes a lot. Hohokam is very odd. I'm not a big fan of it. You can't just jump into it like you could Journey and, like, love it. But yeah, Journey is amazing. Unfinished Swan is amazing. Those are the top two. And I also played Flower.
10 out of 10.
I also played Flower. Flower is about... It's really good. It's really good.
Yeah. I've seen a little bit of it.
The only complaint is when you play on PS4, they make you use motion controls to steer on your controller.
What?
It's not bad, though. That's
the thing. Like...
Yeah, like six axis. But okay. The thing is when I first saw that, I was like, oh, really? And speaking then I started doing it, and I was like, yeah, you should. And then when I started to actually do it, I was like, this is kind of cool. It actually, it's like motion controls done pretty decently. But when you get to the last level, you start to move really, really, really fast. And whereas before you're at a medium speed and you can control it fine with the controller, but when you get to the last level, you're like, "Ah, I'm gonna die!" Running into a bunch of buildings, it's chaos. It's chaos. Whereas it's supposed to be like this final beautiful moment for me, I was just like, "Ah!" But that's my only complaint about that game. I'm sure if you play on PS3, it'd be insanely good. It still was really good. I just that last level really made me wish the motion controls weren't there. Oh well, it was great though. Play the Unfinished One for sure. That game's awesome. That game's really, really good. I played it and I beat it. And on Sunday I went through and I got all the balloons and all the storybooks. So I'm working on that there platinum, even though there is no platinum. So
RIP.
Just all the trophies. There's no platinum. It's just like one of those with just a couple of golds and silvers and no actual platinum, which is very odd.
It's kind of like First Light without a platinum.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
No, First Light has a lot more trophies.
Yeah.
It's like Stealth Inc., A Clone in the Dark on the Vita. I love that game, and I was like, I could platinum this. And then I was like, nope, no I can't. There's no platinum. Same with Titan Attacks on the PlayStation ecosystem. I was like, I should platinum this. There's no platinum. Yeah. Dude, I really want to play their new game, Ultratron. Remember? That came out last week, and it was like, it's like $8, and it's basically like Titan Attacks, but like a twin-stick shooter. I'm like, frick, this looks cool. So I still might do that. Yeah, it looks cool. Anyway, so I played the Unfinished One. I played Flower. Those are the two that I was like, mentally remember that, because you should talk about that on the podcast. I played Destiny.
Destiny. We beat 35.
Yeah, we beat Skolas' face in.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, I was listening to the Planet Destiny podcast, and they were talking about how so hard that encounter is. And it very much is, but I was like, proud of us that we figured out our own strategy without like anybody's help.
Right.
Like, we just figured it out. I was thinking about making a video of that, but I haven't done it yet because I can't freaking figure out how to. Dude, I've been having an issue. You can download past broadcasts, but when you download them, they download as FLVs and not MP4s.
What?
And then you can convert them from FLV to MP4s with a converter, and then. But I was like, oh, that should be fine. And then I should be able to drag it into Sony Vegas. That's what a lot of people do, apparently. I Googled it. And I did it. I converted it. And then I went to drag it, the new MP4 into Sony Vegas. Didn't drag it into Sony Vegas. So I don't freaking know what to do now. So I don't know. I would love to upload Twitch highlights and be able to edit them and whatnot. I can upload regular, just raw stuff from Twitch. But I cannot upload, I can't, download it and edit it. Which I'll figure it out. It's just, for now, I'm at, a standstill. Like, I don't freaking know what to do. I did everything I was supposed to, and it's not working, so I don't know. I'll do some Googling. Let's see. What else did I play? Let me just open my PS4 and see what else I played. I know.
What do you want to play? Pokemon.
No, I don't even own a Nintendo system.
Dude, okay, I gotta tell you, I got a little Splatoon story right now out. While you're turning on your crap.
Okay, go for it.
So back when I played specifically, I had Halo 3, Halo Reach, RuneScape. Those three games I played all the time. And I played nothing else.
That's how it goes.
And
sometimes.
But, like, I mean, of course I need some, like, music while I'm playing RuneScape, you know, or something.
Of course, of course.
So I had, there was this website called playlist.com. It's kind of like Grooveshark.
Ah, back in the days before Spotify.
Or, yeah, it was like a weak version of Spotify. You could make your playlists and share them with your friends and add people. So it was cool. It was like all my people at my middle school would add each other on it and stuff. And we would share our songs. But nice. They had like freaking, it was like music, only it was like YouTube poops, like crap. It was weird, the weirdest thing. And there was like one song. It was like some weird Cosby rap.
And there Bill was like Cosby kids. Rap?
Yes, I will literally find it.
Was it about like pudding?
Yes, there was pudding. And there was Pokemon.
This sounds
there was
amazing.
Children selling bicycles.
This sounds great. I really want
to
hear this.
I listened to it so much. I do not know why.
You're an oddball, although I would most likely listen to it as well. Anyways, so going through my recent activities, I found that I played Aether 1. I forgot about that because I played it for about an hour and a half, 2 hours. And then I was like, I'm not a fan, and sorry. Yeah. And then I played The Witcher a little bit. And then Persona.
I want to play it so bad.
Every week, Persona. Every day, Persona.
You can watch that later.
I will. That's it for all I have been playing, and all Eric's been playing too. Don't forget him. He's over there to the right. Yeah. Wait, nope, right there. When you're to my right on the camera, but I have to point left. You got to point the other way.
I'm to your orbital.
We need to touch.
You're screens. To my right, from where. This is. Also, there's like.
I'm the other direction as to where you pointed.
Really?
On the setup. Yeah, right there.
That's weird because, like, when you were streaming, well, when we streamed, like, the last one, you were over
there. I was still.
Whatever.
I was to the left. I'm almost positive. I've always been to the left. I don't know.
I don't know.
Well.
I just remember, but whatever. Yeah.
I think your memory is a bit hazy. I think those.
Wait, is it, like, flipped? Oh, yeah, that's right. It's flipped.
I think so, your oracles. Yeah, it's. Yeah. The camera.
I've succumbed to the oracles.
Yep. The oracles have clouded your memory. So, I didn't know that was the thing oracles did. Maybe Gorgons did that. They went back and changed your memory. That's what happened. Now the Gorgons are just Time Lords. That's what's going on. They're just changing time.
Yeah.
So, let's talk about the news. Time for the news.
The news.
So,
Shia LaBeouf.
Shia LaBeouf. Just do it! Sorry. We're just going to interject that like every 5-10 minutes.
Yeah.
What do you want to talk about? If you see this list of topics that I have compiled here,
yeah.
There's a decent amount. And then,
since
we have no shows to talk about, normally, for you new listeners out there, we talk about the news, and then we talk about what the shows and what happened in the
maybe
shows.
Maybe people will actually watch our podcast since we don't spoil everything.
Since we're not just spoiling all the finales.
It's kind of true. We spoil like everything, and not everyone watches all the shows we watch. So.
It's a spoiler cast, mate. YOLO.
Yeah,
So yeah, all of our shows are done for now. Like, it's done. I think we should talk about this news, and then we can spend as much time as we want until
Windows 10.
Until that's what you want to talk about? Oh,
yes.
Oh, I am so hyped for Windows 10.
Last night I saw it on my screen. I was like, "What? What?
By
what
the
is
way,
this?
You did not let me finish my thought, mate. No. Get ready. You're like just cutting you off. But
what did
yeah,
it make a segue?
We can.
Segue.
It was a good segue, but I gotta bring it back because I'm talking about our plans. We're after we talk about the news, we can just talk about Destiny and what we did in the past week of Destiny for like freaking 20 minutes or whatever, however long we need to fill. Anyways, Windows 10. Back to your beautiful segue, Eric. It was beautiful.
Yes,
it was great.
Windows 10. A lot of people at least who have a legitimate copy of Windows 8.1, whatever your situation is, Teddy. I don't know how you... Did you get, like, a notice?
It is on the screen right now, Eric, and I also have an article. Let's talk about Windows 10 here. Let me go to the article real quick. So, article on IGN by Matt Porter. Microsoft has announced that Windows 10 will be available on from July 29th. So, July 29th is the date that it will officially launch. People that are eligible, which are Windows 7 or 8.1 users, will receive a user notification in their taskbar notifying them that they can upgrade, which is right here. So I saved it to show people. Blah, 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 Windows 10. Amazing new features. I have never been excited for an OS.
Right.
Now I freaking am. I am very excited for Windows 10. I don't know why.
Because I heard that people who already have Windows 10, I've heard that they've made really good improvements.
Yeah, dude. Freaking, I might, and I also wanted to tie this in with my other topic. This is very selfish of a topic. I might have a new computer by then.
Really?
Yeah. So, I got my tax returns, and I also graduated, so I have, you know, graduation money, because that's a thing, apparently. People are like, here, have money, you graduated, and I'm like, thanks! So, I have that as well. So, in the past couple of weeks, I've just been putting money into my checking account and, like, not touching it. So, I'm, like, growing a decent amount of money, and I get paid tomorrow, so I'm gonna go put in this Alabama tax return and a graduation check and my paycheck and see how much. If I can, I might just be able to save for like a month and get a really beast PC, to be honest.
Dude, that'd be awesome.
And I can keep this one and stream off of this one. See what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? Yeah. But the only problem is, one of the reasons why I would just get a whole new PC instead of upgrading, yeah. Because my computer is a bit loud, and it's a little bit annoying. So I was looking on CyberPower, and I was going through the customization options for desktops, and the customization options for your fans, you can add in, like, super silent fans. And there's like there's an actual one that's like ultra silent, low profile fans, and I'm like, yes,
nice,
yes, please. So I might do that in the next month or two. But my parents got me a laptop. They've been saying that they were gonna get me a laptop for graduation. What? I know, this is like dropping news on you, mate.
Dropping bombs.
They said that they were gonna get me a laptop for graduation. So I was like, I have always been saying, Don't buy it. Let me find a decent one, and then if I need to pitch in a little money, I will, to get a decent laptop. But
so you mean you showed him the laptop that you wanted, and you were just like, just do it.
No, gosh, dude. Make your dreams come true. Yesterday you said tomorrow. Anyways, yeah, no, I didn't do that. Not at all. That meme did not exist then. What I did was I went to cyberpowerpc.com, and they had a laptop, and they had a $1,200 laptop for $800.
Laptop.
Lap slop. Slop on your lap. Just, that's gross. Anyway, the laptop that I'm getting is like basically better than my computer now. It has like an Intel i7.
Yeah, it's kind of
sad. It has an i7 and a GTX 860. Gosh. So I'm like, holy balls. Good deal there. So I might play, I'm considering just playing PC games for now. I might just play PC games on there and stream through my regular PC. I don't know. These are all ideas. But basically, in the next like little bit, my streaming is going to be upgraded. My games will be upgraded. So, you know, if I ever host a game, a PC game on YouTube, the settings will be higher. So that's cool. Anyway, I thought that was great. And it ties in with this Windows 10 thing. Ryan is also getting a computer in like early July, and he'll be able to get Windows 10. It'll be in good timing for Windows 10. I'm very excited for Windows 10. It's got like, you can play some Xbox games on PC. Like, some Xbox-exclusive games are going to be available on PC, like Fable Legends and stuff like that. It's going to be awesome.
Halo 5 on PC.
It's not happening. It's not happening.
Shush.
It'll happen. It'll happen if you believe. I wish,
but... Do it!
just do it! I've been doing the hand thing every time I do that, by the way. Yeah.
Just do it.
Just do it. Where you like crush your hand and then like
crush your hand, like yeah. Do it.
Yep.
Do
exactly. The Windows 10 is coming on July 29th. July 29th, Windows 10. Very exciting. Much excited. Okay, I'll pick the next news topic since you picked the last one. Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Oh, no. Let's not go there. Eric, do you remember Assassin's Creed Unity? You remember running around?
No, but what's that game?
What's that game? But you remember running around Paris when you first got the game, and you were like, oh, what's this chest over here? Oh, I have to unlock this chest with the mobile app, I guess.
Oh, yeah, that crap.
There will be none of that in Assassin's Creed Syndicate, because Assassin's Creed Syndicate won't even have a companion app. Yes, that game right there. Yeah. Syndicate will not even have a companion app at all. So that is really good news. I like that a lot.
I mean, I liked what they tried to do, but then it tied into the main game. I was like, no.
Yeah. If there's a companion app that's like on its own and you, yeah.
And plus it like made my phone explode.
Yeah, dude, it got your phone. My phone so hot.
Was like burning my pants. So like, what's going on here?
Yeah. But the team wanted to, speaking to Eurogamer, the developer confirmed, the team wanted to focus all their efforts on the core experience. It's a decision likely to be music to the ears of series fans. Last year, Assassin's Creed Unity added the rather unwelcome feature of locking access to certain treasure chests and costumes unless you'd pour hours into the app.
Yeah.
It's true. That was Luke Carmelli on IGN, by the way. So yeah, thank you.
Cool Ubisoft. Idea, but it just... It made me feel like I was getting nowhere with those all the chests on the screen. It was just really bothering me.
Unity is just it was something. You know, I told you I wasn't going to get Syndicate. I'm trying to refocus my mind.
Yeah.
And just forget about the Ezio trilogy. I'm just trying to forget so that I can forget the travesty that they did to it. And
I'm just thinking it as another... Like a different, it is a different thing.
I'm just trying to think of it as in like, oh, I'm this guy in this time period. I don't even, it's no modern thing. Forget about Rebecca and Sean. Just forget about them. They don't exist. You're just in this world and blah, blah. That's what I'm going to try and do for that game.
You know, I feel like they're going to do something about the future. I mean, they've heard it so much since the release of Unity.
It's not. As in, future time periods?
Maybe.
Not gonna happen. They crushed that with Desmond.
They might have, but they still can redeem themselves. They're
not going to. No. See, this is what... See, when I start to think redeem, I start to think, oh, they could. Oh, they could only do this.
Well, and not the Desmond.
They won't. They won't. So I just need to put that in my mind. It's like, oh, no, all it's ever going to be is past time.
Remember when I hated the future blah, or the, blah, blah. Like, remember when I hated, like, the future?
you hated line? The future?
Damn, no, I just didn't like, I'm just exploring and walking around with no weapons or anything, and I felt really...
That's because you didn't understand. You didn't play the early ones.
It was weird. So, it's I mean, amazing. I loved Brotherhood part. Completely. So, I mean, I like the storytelling in the future, or the, what was it, present times, whatever it is in the game. So,
Heroes of the Storm, moving on, because I have so much, that just builds rage inside me.
Speaking of Heroes of the Storm, I need to, after this, I need to update my drivers for it.
I should as well. Heroes of the Storm officially launches. The day you are listening to this, it's out. Officially.
Yeah. So, I mean, I could play it right now, but...
Yeah. But right now, it's the open beta. Tomorrow, it is officially launched. So I don't know what changes that brings.
Right and, now. We should play that because that game was awesome.
I might jump into that on Wednesday. That might be my plan. I'm opening battle.net to see if they have anything to say about it. But Heroes of the Storm officially...
Download our game.
It officially... Blizzard's MMO. Yeah. Blah, blah, blah. Blizzard's MOBA, not MMO. Blizzard has a new MMO. They have a new one, and you didn't even know about it. Project Titan's back, baby.
Oh, no.
No. Heroes of the Storm is Blizzard's MOBA. similar to MOBA. League of Legends or Dota, if you are familiar with those, or Smite. If you
Dota 2.
Dota 2.
Smite.
No, not Dota 2.
Dawn Gate.
Just Dota the first one. Just the first one.
I wonder, whatever happened to Dota?
I don't know. Is that even like available on Steam?
I don't
know.
It's not. I've looked it up before. It's just not a thing.
Oh, man.
It's
weird.
Silly Dota. Yeah.
Silly Dota. Forget about it. It doesn't matter anymore.
Wow.
Yeah, launch date detected June 2nd, 2015. That's all it says. Click to learn more. So, let's see.
Click to make your dreams come true.
Make your dreams. No, I'm to celebrate. Live stream event on June 1st in London. That's passed. Sorry, suckers. Let's see here. For people who have played the beta, they're like, there is no, or the betas and the alphas, it's like, there is no more wipes on your progress. This is it. Go. So, we might jump into this. We might stream this on Wednesday or something. Yeah, I'm not streaming because I can't do that yet, but Eric might. YOLO. YOLO swag. I was putting words into his mouth. He's probably not.
Yep.
He's probably not going to do that. But yeah, we'll be playing it on Wednesday. We'll let you, maybe. We'll let you know. If we play it this week, we'll let you know how it went.
Hands out.
Because what, we did like it. We did like it when we did play it before.
Oh yeah, dude. I liked the map. The map features, they're like different each map.
Yeah, the map, it like the
as many whatever events, sort of.
Whatever map you're on basically just completely changes how you play.
Yeah.
And I don't know, I liked it a lot. So what do you want to talk about?
Because
I picked that last one out, just trying to get away from the Desmond topic that I.
Rob Desmond.
I'm crying for you audio listeners. Just pouring tears.
Tomb Raider, mate.
You want to watch this trailer?
Sure.
Basically,
Sure.
Yeah, Rise of the Tomb Raider has a E3 teaser trailer, which is basically like, oh, here's a teaser for our full trailer that we're going to show at E3, I guess. I don't know. All right, I have it queued up. Do you wanna?
Yeah, I'm at 0000.
0000. You forgot the colon, mate. 0:00.
0:00.
Hashtag wrecked.
/1:35.
There you go.
Are you happy?
Yes. All right, let's play in 3, 2, 1.
Let's play.
Let's play. Let's play. Oh my gosh, it's loud. Okay.
Throughout history, the boldest have dared to go further. They risk death. And in doing so, live on forever. What drives these few to the ends of the earth? The desire to discover something more. The search for something greater. The world is full of unanswered questions. Beyond all limits or reason, the answers await.
Don't die or anything. I spoke too soon. Death!
Death is among us, mate.
Nope, not a big deal or anything. NBD. See, this is the image I've been seeing right here.
Discovering the secrets of the world is the only way to live.
Inception music! That's an awesome trailer.
Yeah, okay. I can tell you what happens, like, here. In the first,
reboot...
No, it's not a spoiler. I'm just saying... It's telling you how it's like a reboot of like the whole story of Lara Croft.
I would assume
Where she's like a little girl going on an adventure.
That's usually
Then she becomes like this Indiana Jones freaking legit.
That's usually what reboots
are. Yeah. But it's awesome how she does it because you know she's famous for having like dual wield guns. Yeah. Yeah, I won't say more.
Okay.
It's kind of a spoiler.
Anyways, yeah, I still need to play that. I have it. I will play it.
It's a great game. The ending is so cool.
Yeah, and it's not too long too. So I'm yeah, maybe one weekend I'll just jump into that and try and crush it. Crush it with my fists. I need to just do it.
Do it.
Oh man. So something that is very near and dear to my heart is a little game. A little game called Wildstar.
Wildstar.
Wildstar is going to free to play in August. But you know what's awesome about this, Eric? Well, yeah. There's a couple awesome things about what they've been doing here. Them nice folk over at Carbine Studios. They put out an FAQ, frequently asked question, basically just saying the majority of what people would ask and most of the details here. They haven't put a date on free to play yet, which is interesting to me.
Really?
But yeah, I would assume August though. I would assume not. Actually, I don't know. I would assume not too late in the fall though. Like,
yeah,
not too late at all. Like August or September, you know. I don't expect it to be like November. It'd be crazy. But one of the cool things is that they're doing with this is that they, with the launch trailer, they're basically treating this as like a party. Instead of everyone is always like, oh, free to play the game's dead.
Right.
Whereas they're like, hey, you can play the game now, which I thought was a great way to market it at least. Also, one of the awesome things that I saw is that you can play free to play, like most free to play games, you can play free to play and you can play the signature, which is the membership. But the thing that's different between this and other free-to-play MMOs is that in the middle of the free-to-play and the signature, there is... They have this thing called loyalty perks, whereas...
Loyalty perks.
The longer you play free-to-play, or the amount of months that you had paid subscription or whatever, you earn loyalty perks. So I'm going to get a certain amount of perks because I subbed for like 4 months and I bought the game. So I'm going to come in with a couple of loyalty perks. Whereas like, for example, let's talk about how these loyalty perks work. There, for one example, there are circles, which is like basically you can make a circle, which is in your chat channel, which is like you can combine like two guilds, or like a guild and a friend, and that's a circle. And for free members, you cannot create a circle, I believe. But with loyalty perks, you can, and you can, or you can join one circle as free. But with loyalty, you can join like five, and you can create. So it's stuff like that, like guilds. As a free to play member, of course, you can't create a guild. And you can't invite people, but with loyalty, I'm sure eventually you can invite. Maybe eventually you can create. Right. So, I don't know. There's not too many details with this, but there is a lot of details, but this is not what they've said yet.
Right.
I imagine that, like, maybe if you play for, like, a year on free-to-play, then you get almost all of the signature perks.
Yeah.
Not all, but, like... I imagine people like you who played RuneScape for like 7 years,
speaking,
if you do that as free, like, you're just going to be a member.
Well, okay, yeah, like, this reminds me, I don't know, it was like 2 or 3 years ago, RuneScape, they came up with this loyalty points thing, and every month, if you were subscribed and you had a membership, you would get loyalty points, and that you can spend those loyalty points on cosmetic items. And it was a pretty cool system they had.
Yeah.
This incentive to get membership.
Yeah. So this is
it's a little different.
Yeah, this is it's way for different.
When your plan is free to play.
Yeah. That sounds just like that sounds like just perks for when you're a
perks
member.
Perks, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know. This is cool. I am definitely going to jump back into this game in August when it goes free to play or whenever in the fall. Like, I'm going to. And by then, I should have a new computer. And I can at least maybe run it on my Intel laptop and be fine, because it's horribly... I love this game, and I ran it at 20 FPS. That shows you how good this game is. I love this game and played like 80 hours of it, and I ran it at 20 frames the whole time. On a good day, 20. Most of the time, like 15, 10. So, yeah, it was bad, but I really loved it. So, maybe my new laptop can actually run it at 60 frames. Or by then, maybe I'll have a new computer and I can play it and stream it. Maybe in the fall, I'll be streaming this. This would be fun. But I want to get back into it a little bit. Just a little.
It's a little.
Just a little.
A little. A little.
I want to... I have a character that's, like, level 35 and the level cap's 50. Like, out of any, like, big MMO with a, like, a big leveling stage... Like, WildStar is the one that I'm closest to endgame. So I played WildStar a lot, so I'm very curious as to what the endgame is, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I definitely want to do that.
I'm going to try hell.
Exactly, in the words of Skrillex.
Yes.
So, mate, do you want to end on depressing news, or do we want to get the depressing news out of the way and end on good news?
Let's get it out of the way.
Okay, that's what I would assume. So earlier this week, Vita owners around the world panicked in their seats when they got this news.
The two Vita owners.
Wow.
Me and you.
Basically, self-burn. Basically, Andrew House, the, let me find it. I'll find his title real quick, but he's somewhere... Very high up in Destiny. No,
yeah, in
somewhere
Destiny.
Very high
level
up.
Level 34, you know.
Six flawless cards at Trials of Osiris. No, he is the president and group CEO of Sony Computer Entertainment. So very high up at Sony. He came out and basically said that they're considering the Vita as a legacy platform along the lines of a PSP and a PS2. And I was like, what? And then apparently everyone was like, somebody tweeted at Greg Miller and they're like, can we be worried about the Vita now? And he's like, yes, this is completely a worrisome statement. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is awful. But then apparently later, this is the article where later... They came out and said that they clarified it, which basically meant that they consider the Vita 1000 as an Eric's model, like the first model of the Vita, as a legacy platform. And I was like, that's kind of a cop-out. But if that's what he means, good. Because they was like, we'll continue to support the Vita, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, thanks. But I freaking love my Vita, dude. I freaking love my Vita so much.
It's pretty great.
Oh! One of the games I was playing in the past week. So, in the past week, yeah, I remember 40 minutes into the podcast, but...
Wow.
It's not something you would remember. So I sat down one day, and I had to go to sleep early because I was going to work the next day super early.
Play Netflix.
That doesn't count. So I sat down on my bed... And I was watching a Twitch stream, and I was like, let's just play my Vita. And I was scrolling through my games, and I saw Welcome Park, the game the tutorials of your camera and your touchscreen and all sorts of stuff like that on your Vita. And I'm like, let me just see here. And then I opened the game, and I looked at the trophies, and I was like, I could get that. Let me see. And I just spent like an hour and a half getting trophies in Welcome Park. And I still want to get all of the trophies, so just tossing that out there. It was a lot of fun. It was a surprising amount of fun. So, that's one of the games I've played. With a little bit of shame in my voice. But, like, so many good games on here, dude. I have Limbo, which I still need to play.
Limbo is so good. I played, like, 9 times.
I have Rayman Origins. I have Shovel Knight. I have freaking Stealth Inc., which is awesome. Wipeout, the newest Sly Cooper game. Uncharted Golden Abyss is really good. I also really like PlayStation also. I don't know, the Vita is a fantastic thing. Like, some days I just sit on my couch and play my Vita for like hours. I love it. So don't stop. I don't know. It's sad that they would even like that there would even be hints of people of Sony not supporting the Vita. But it makes sense because the Vita, it's not sold super well in North America, of course. Right. It's a bummer that it hasn't. But it's crazy because people who have their Vita, who have a Vita, just love it. It's like they love their Vita. People who have Vitas are Vita enthusiasts. But people who don't have Vitas don't know anything about it, don't know it exists, and just play on their 3DSs because 3DS
has trumped it on the market. Flagship of portable devices.
Yeah, it's true. I kind of want both, to be honest. I wish I had every console, you know. Play that Splatoon that came out last week. Everybody's been enjoying Splatoon.
Dude, I've seen a little bit of it.
Oh my gosh. I think it's funny that I've been seeing stuff on the R Gaming subreddit that's like about Splatoon, and apparently people can't, you know, it's an online game, so people will just leave messages in the hub world. Like, they'll just, you'll see their character and they'll just be sitting there with a message above their heads. And since it's like a family friendly game and a game for, you know, actual, not actual, but like more hardcore older gamers, people will like screenshot messages that they see that are like little kids. And I've seen some that are like, my parents left me at Target. Like, with a frowny face. I've seen a couple like those, and they're freaking fantastic. It's so funny. It's kind of sad, but it's funny. Like, there was this one kid that was just sitting in the corner that was like, my parents left me.
Oh my gosh.
Like, let's see. Yeah. Like this. Here, I'm going to show this to the the stream. It's this kid, this person who left a message, and it says Bush did 9/11. And there's two towers planes. So yeah, there's messages like that just hanging out through the world, which I find funny. So yeah, that's the depressing news. Good news for you PC players out there. XCOM 2 has been announced, and it is a PC exclusive.
Yeah.
And that's about all I have to say about that because...
Yeah.
I mean, there are people who loved XCOM Enemy Unknown. And, like, I played it. And I'm like, this is kind of cool, but it's, like, a strategy game. And I got other games to play. And I mean, it was cool. But I just... It's never... Right. Like, hardcore RTS strategy games aren't my thing at all.
Right. I'm kind of the same way. But, I mean, some games I'm okay with, like...
Yeah.
City Skylines is cool.
I mean, I didn't dislike it. I liked it. I just didn't sink billions of hours into it like other people. I saw somebody, Dan Stapleton, the reviews editor at IGN, tweet out a picture of how many hours he has in XCOM, and it was like 444, and I'm like, dang. So, and he was the one who revealed XCOM 2. I was like, man, good for that guy. That'd be like if I revealed Destiny 2. Which would just be insanity. Please, Bungle.
Bungle.
Bungle, why? Anyways.
Bungle.
So, Destiny. House of Wolves continues to be awesome. Loving House of Wolves.
See, I mean...
The only complaint is space. It's more of an issue than it was before. That's my only complaint.
You know, I've liked everything from House Wolves. Everything's been solid.
So good.
But there's some people that have pointed out some things about it. I mean, as much as Prison is awesome, and... PvP on the PvP side, it's great. I love Trials. It's great. It just needs... The cheaters need to go.
Fantastic.
But I just feel like some of the mechanics in PoE need a little bit of refining. I mean, I like Quadron and Uroks. Those are two cool boss fights. But, I mean... Sometimes, like, for people who aren't as... I mean, hey, I mean, we're pretty good at the game. So, I mean, who for people who aren't maybe as that skilled at, in Destiny, playing 35 skill loss is ridiculous because you kind of have to just be lucky with the burns almost. Like, I don't know, man.
I disagree. I think Skolas is fantastic. It's a really good fight. The mechanics are awesome. You have to have a specific strategy. And with Arc Burn, with the different burns, you have to adapt your strategy to that. That's why Prison of Elders is awesome, because it's always changing.
I like that. But, like, if I think it's kind of ridiculous that Ad can two-shot me with his pistol.
I mean, yeah.
That shouldn't be happening. The boss should be two-shotting me. I want a boss battle, not an Ad battle.
Yeah, I don't know. I disagree, because, I mean, the ads are just as much as part of the fight as the boss. I don't know.
That's, like, one thing I don't really get. I just want a really cool boss battle.
But you've gotten that. That's what... I don't know. You've gotten that a billion times. That's why I like
Atheon so much.
Yeah, but those are raids. This is Prison of Elders. It's a horde mode.
Yeah.
The boss is thrown into the horde mode. You know?
Right.
I don't agree. But Prison of Elders is awesome. My opinions are that Prison of Elders is awesome. I love the Skolas fight. I love the mechanics of the Skolas fight. It's really rough with Arcburn, but it's not always gonna be Arcburn.
Like, it's not the fight that really gets me put off about Prison of Elders, it's really the loot. The guns. They're horrible. They really are. There's nothing useful from the PoE weapons. All the trial stuff is better. Nothing can compare to the trials weapons. So it's kind of sad that the end game on PvP is better than the PvE end game stuff. I wish that was balanced out a little bit more.
Not everything can be top tier.
Yes, you know what I mean?
Like, not everything can be a Fatebringer. Not everything can be a Jewel of Osiris or Messenger.
But this is level 35. I don't need a Messenger. I just want a better weapon that can be comparable to endgame content from the past.
But see, raids. The Prison of Elders is dropping Queen's weapons, not Prison of Elder weapons.
Yeah, in level 35, it drops weapons with
ranks. Yeah. Yeah, okay. But I'm just saying, like, Queen's weapons are not very good, but
they're okay. I mean,
Prison of Elders weapons are all right. Prison of Elders weapons are pretty good.
There's nothing
decent
good about them. They look cool. They look awesome.
Wolf Slayer's Claw is Shank great. Burn it's is a useless. Great auto rifle, and that's basically the only
auto
guns
rifles
we've
are still
seen.
Useless.
Yeah, I know, but as an auto rifle, it's a really good auto rifle. What I'm saying is that we haven't seen many Prison of Elders guns, Eric. As in, like, they don't drop for us. We've gotten Queen's guns.
Yeah, I've looked them up. Everything has shank burn, dreg burn, and you have a chance of getting captain burn, but that's like the only useful one.
Yeah, the burns themselves aren't very good, but like the guns are like pretty good.
They should
guns.
Just have another perk from like the worldwide perk, selection, and just throw it in there for another chance at something decent. I mean, I don't know.
Also, this is a thing, people who don't watch the streams. Eric thinks that anything that isn't God tier is trash. So, like, I'm saying these guns are decent. These guns are all right guns. They're, like, tier 2 guns. But Eric's like, no, they're awful. They're trash. Like, they're decent guns.
I'm not going to use a Fatebringer over a Thorn in PvP.
I know. That's the point, though. The Fatebringer's still a good gun. Like, take that.
But it's trash in PvP.
But it's not trash. It's a decent gun. That's the point. It's not terrible. Have you used it?
I didn't say terrible. I said comparable.
Comparable, yeah. But you just call anything that is not figures, last word, speech. Red Death, Thorn, Messenger, and Hawkmoon.
It's not my fault that the meta is like this crazy.
I know. But those are the top tier. Those are the god tier guns. Anything below it is not trash.
No.
Something that is slightly below is a good gun.
Vision is really good in PvP.
I'm just saying. You gotta learn to appreciate other things.
I'm just saying.
Not everything is trash.
The main point is, like, I should at least have one gun that can compare, or like, you know, yeah. Trump, a VOC, or a Fatebringer. I want something.
That's not going to happen, or because that's, the Vision and the Fatebringer are ridiculous for legendaries. Like,
yes, they are.
With them ascended, it's going to be hard to even create a gun that is better.
Yes. You know what I mean? It's true.
But I
wish there was something at least comparable, maybe something that looks different and has a different burn, with some maybe a little bit different. I don't know.
That I agree that they're not god tier guns. They're Prison Builders guns, but they're not bad. They're not
they
bad
look
guns.
Awesome.
And you can re-roll them, so if you get a decent.
I'm not sure. I thought you can just re-roll the Queen's one. I wasn't sure about.
Yeah, I wasn't sure about that either. But in Planet Destiny podcast, they seem to be pretty sure that you could. So I don't know. I'm fairly sure that you can. Fairly sure. Eric's doing fact checking. But I don't know. Learn to appreciate things. You should go
I mean, I love my guns that I have. I use them because they're useful.
But you only use the top tier guns, which is fine, but that doesn't mean that you have to call everything else trash. That's the only thing I'm saying is like,
I mean, I use the word trash very, very lightly.
Like
I can say, okay, listen. Fatebringer is trash if there's a solar burn. That's given because it's a solar burn in Fatebringer.
Yeah,
is
that's archer. Decent.
That's thinking this like, I think every gun is bad because it's not top. No, it's
usually what happens. Like for example, Ryan rolled a decent roll. Like this just happens all the time. We went on Iron Banner one week and Ryan was re-rolling a gun. He was like, "Hey, I got these perks. What do you think?" And they were really good perks. And I was like, "Nah, it's trash.
I don't even
keep
know
re-rolling."
What perks it was.
Yeah, I don't know either. I'm just using this for an example. I remember the conversation. I remember I was like, "That's a really good gun," and Eric's like, "Nah, keep rolling. It's not good." And I'm like,
"Well, if it was a rocket launcher, he needs that grenades and horseshoes, though."
But you don't need those two exact perks. You can get one of the perks and be fine. You know what I mean? Still a good gun. It's not trash.
Oh well, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta learn to appreciate love, in general, Eric. Love. These guns love you. And they need love back.
I don't know if you can reroll.
Yeah, I'm still doing fact checking, but it's fine. I don't know. You might be able to. You can't reroll, but
can't reroll because they have the perks like the drag burn and all that. You can't just reroll that.
You get different drops though.
Yeah.
As in when they drop, you can get the same gun with different perks.
Yes. So, similar, I mean, if you did get a Captain Burn, that would be good.
Yeah, the weird thing about the Captain one is that it's a chance at suppressing a Captain. Which is,
RNG.
Like, really? Like, RNG in a gun. Like, yeah, that's...
Dude, Hawk Moon is basically RNG, but...
Yeah, that's why I don't use it as much. Which is.
But the thing is, as much as it's RNG, there's a higher chance of... Yeah. Getting the extra damage.
Yeah, it's a pretty high chance. Yeah, I'm in no means saying go out and use these Prison Builders guns in PvP and like use them over your great guns. I'm just saying like you can use them and be fine. They're all right guns. If you're people like us or people unlike us who don't have your 365 Fatebringer and your 365 Vision and all that, and you go in and you're just like a normal dude, maybe you just bought the game and you just got up to level cap and you're like, "Hey, let's try this Prison Builders out," and then you get a PoE gun and then you're like, "Oh, let's try," like, that's fine, you're gonna do okay. You might struggle a little bit more, you're not gonna steamroll over everything, but you're gonna do fine. You know, that's all I'm saying. So, we should talk about the Trials of Osiris map and how we liked it compared to last week. That should be our last topic. I like that topic. Even though
so
I came
right
up
now?
With it. Yeah, sure.
Okay.
I mean, do you have anything else to add on the previous one before we move on?
I don't know. No, not really.
All right.
Trials of Osiris. Pantheon was the map. And we went in knowing that it was going to be a crazy sniper fest, and it was. Oh boy!
It, you know, to be honest, it wasn't as much as I expected. You know, like it still was. There were still people sniping on that on the waterfall hallway a lot. But like that's the thing. I expected everyone to like post up at one lane and just snipe. And that would be it. There was a lot more rushing than I thought there would be. I don't know.
Yeah, it's true.
It was interesting. It was interesting. But the thing is like it was a lot harder of a map than the Burning Shrine. The Burning Shrine we figured out almost immediately. We figured out what to do and how to play it. Whereas in Pantheon, it was quite difficult. We lost we got a loss on like two scorecards before we just went and got all three flawlesses. Then, you know, like after that we had figured it out. We had realized how to play the map and whatnot. And to be honest, it's not something that you can like explain to someone easily. It's a complex map to play. And once you kind of have to just I told the stream this when we were streaming is like synergy is a good word for it. As in like you have to be really on point with your team. Like with communication or with not communicating, like you just need to at some point you know where each of your teammate is going and you know where to go yourself. You know how each other play and right. You know how the map plays.
Me and you
just practice.
We're just like going ham with the sniping.
Yeah. It's
on that one hallway.
It's a lot of like play a lot with the same people and you'll do well. Like
right.
we you know, it'll take a little bit to figure out, but once we figure it out, we've got it. And, like, me and you and Ryan have been going through, like, everything in House of Wolves, and, like, we're doing great. Mm-hmm. We just
Skolas. Know how to play with each other.
Yeah. We beat Skolas. We beat Quadron. I like that Quadron fight a lot, by the way. Just tossing that out there. I like that a lot. I like the only one person could break the detains after you kill one dude that gives you the buff. I thought that was cool. Which makes me excited to play that again tonight. It's gonna be great.
Right.
I've been using Praetus in Pantheon because it has an. I ascended it and then I was like, holy crap! I forgot how stable this gun is. It's so good. The stability on that gun is insane. It's awesome. I don't know. There's not much else to say. Just kind of play it a bit. Don't worry about your score. And you'll figure it out. Once you figure it out, you'll know. You'll know it. You'll just know it. Yeah. One tip for the map specifically is, like, you can either choose to be defensive or you can choose to rush. That's what we've been noticing. We sort of noticed that some teams will just sit back and have each person watch a lane, and the majority of teams will just choose a lane and rush it. Like, we had this one game with a Titan, a Hunter, I think it was two Hunters. But each time, there was a flashbang in middle and an arc bolt in middle.
That was so irritating.
Every round, the same spot, and they just kept rushing middle. Eventually we knew what was going on, and also a tip for Trials of Osiris in general is just don't be predictable like these guys, because we start to realize their strategy and turn around and like be defensive. But yeah, so if you do rush, try and mix it up.
Yeah,
there you go. There's a couple of brief tips for Trials of Osiris Pantheon, but it doesn't matter because it's gone now. If it comes back in the rotation, there it is, and that can be applied to any sort of long range map. Oh dude, I wonder what it's going to be this week. I wonder what Trials is going to be this week. I kind of want Trials to be on
probably one of the new DLC maps.
That's what I thought it would be this week, and it wasn't. And I was like, okay.
Apparently it was told that it was going to be a DLC map, but yeah. It wasn't specific. So and it was
them tricksy little bungle.
Yeah,
but I don't know. I really want it to be Widow's Court because that map looks so good.
Sniper Fest again.
Yeah, it would be the same thing. But
like, I think that map's a little big, though. I don't know.
Yeah, it would. But the Pantheon strategy would work pretty similar to how it would work on Widow's Court. It would just be a little bit different as to how it's laid out. But it's still similar in size. It's a little bit bigger, but not much bigger than Pantheon. Pantheon's a pretty big map.
Yeah.
So yeah, Trials of Osiris. It's really good. Play it. It's a lot of fun. After this, I think me and Eric will just, like, play with a friend, even though not getting rewards because I like the game mode so much.
Right.
Maybe. It might be time. Ryan almost.
J-Money. Yeah. Help J-Money. That'd be cool.
Ryan almost might be home by the time we're done. It's like 9 already. So the drope, and then we can get out of here. It's come to that time of the podcast again. We talk about the drope by PlayStation Powerhouse Ryan Clements. PlayStation blog.
Drope.
The drope. There is something interesting on this drope, but we will talk about it when we get to it at the end. Because it's interesting. Arcade Archives Renegade for the PS4. I've seen a lot of these Arcade Archives where they're just bringing back arcade games. There was like 2 of them last week. Class of Heroes 2G for the PS3 looks like a, if I were to guess, a 2D RPG, yeah. But I don't know. The Escapists for PS4. That game looks really interesting. It's like an RPG, but like a prison-based escape RPG. Like, you work out in the day. It's like a day and night cycle. It's like a time cycle, like Persona, where you can't waste time. So you gotta, like, you go and you choose to go over here and work out and get your strength stat up so you can, like, beat up guards and stuff like that. It's like an RPG, but about getting out of jail. Looks really cool. Skulls of the Shogun, Bonafide Edition, PS4. Not sure what that is.
Bonafide Edition.
It is a mashup of turn-based strategy and fighting game flair. Interesting.
Fighting game flair. That sounds fancy.
It does. Sparkle Unleashed. Three-way cross-buy.
Wow.
That sounds interesting.
Sparkle.
Sparkle Unleashed. Sparkle. You gotta unleash the sparkle.
This next one, though.
Yeah, Super Exploding Zoo. That is it. That's a PS4 and Vita digital cross-buy that is free on PlayStation Plus. That's one of the free ones.
Oh.
Wait, did we even discuss that? That came out this past week. We'll go to that after the drop because it's actually really good. Tetris Ultimate for the Vita. That's been out for PS4 for a bit. And then this one game. One of you guys might remember this from E3. I don't know if it was last year or 2 years ago. They showed off a game with a giant lady and dinosaurs and animals and, like, wilderness and barbarians, and you can, like, play as all the different animals and whatnot. And it's called Wander, and it is out this week. They showed that off at E3 and then did no marketing up until release. Me and Eric were like, what? It's freaking weird.
Yeah.
It is
They didn't, like, advertise it or...
Nothing.
Nothing.
We were just looking on the drop. I literally just sent a message on our group chat that was like, guys, remember that weird non-combat MMO where you could play as animals that they showed off at E3? And Eric's like, yeah. I was like, it's out this week. It's like, really? Like, yup. I don't know. It's kind of odd. Anyways, we lied to you. We're not ending on the drop this week. We will end on the PlayStation Plus games for June. Because... They're pretty good. At least the first one is definitely good. The others, interesting. Snap. Also, Elder Scrolls Online next Tuesday. I'm very excited. I'm going to be streaming that. Have you picked that up yet?
No.
Oh, okay. You should get on that because it's next Tuesday. It is 8 days from now. 8 days. Here's the PS Plus games. Also, before we move on to PS Plus. The PS Plus. Gosh dang. Before we move on to those, those games that we just mentioned on the drop, you can either go get them right now or wait a couple of hours for the store maintenance because this will come out on a Tuesday.
Yeah.
There you go. PlayStation Plus games for June. Starting off with a big bang. Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes for PS4. Is free. So there you go.
Yeah, this is freaking awesome. I've been wanting to play that.
It's very interesting. Yeah, I'll jump into it. I will not... Everyone says jump into that if you haven't played a Metal Gear, but, like, don't expect to know what's going on at all. And I'm like, I won't expect to know what's going on. I played the first Metal Gear and I had no idea what was going on. But the gameplay looks awesome, so I'll play that for a little stealth. You know, it's free. These are free games. It's not costing you anything but time to try them out. Skulls of the Shogun Bonafide Edition. Oh, that was one we read on the drop.
Okay.
We can try out. We were like, oh, I wonder what this is. We can try it out, because it's free. Super Exploding Zoo, the other one that we were talking about. Futuridium EP Deluxe for Vita and PS4. That one looks like a... I don't know. It looks like kind of similar to Race to the Sun, but more arcadey, where it's just like, you know, flying through the world, getting points and whatnot. It looks very colorful. I'm into that. That's going to be the one I'm going to try for sure. Call of Juarez Gunslinger for PS3. I heard that one was pretty decent. Cloudberry Kingdom, PS3. Which is like a 2D platformer of death. Similar to I Want to Be the Boshi. It Gosh. Looks very similar. I watched the video for the PlayStation Plus games, and it was like, it showed off this game, and it was like, good luck, because you're going to die. And okay, I don't want to do that. So yeah, if you're into putting yourself through 2D platformer hell, look into that game on the PS3. And officially, that is the end of the Gamergist Duo podcast number 27. You can find us on iTunes. You can find us on YouTube. YouTube.com/TBestiac. TBESTIAC. You can find me on Twitter at TBestiac. I just spelled it. You can find Eric at Twitter. At Legend PBM. He changed it.
Like a boss.
He's a boss. Also, you can rate us on iTunes. Reach out to us on Twitter if you like the
subscribe to Teddy's YouTube.
I actually, if I can figure out freaking, like I said earlier in the podcast, if I can figure out how to edit freaking stream highlights, there will be a ton of videos up on there. I had like four planned in my head, and then I'm like, it's not working. So, but I also kind of want to record some stuff, like me and Ryan playing Trials Fusion would be fun, stuff like that. So be on the lookout there. Reach out, like I was saying, reach out to us on Twitter if you like the podcast and don't have a means of contacting us other than that. Your weekly reminder, E3 is coming up very soon, and I am so excited. And that should bring us to a close. Eric, do you have something random to show us this week?
Yeah. I had this
Chick-fil-A 2 days
ago.
Dang, bro.
It's a peach shake.
Why do you still have the cup?
Because it just sits here.
That's kind of messy, mate. Might want to clean that up. Toss it in the trash.
No, I don't remember when I had this. I think it must have been... It had to be, like, yesterday or something. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It was yesterday because I came home from freaking
Yesterday's
Indianapolis.
Not too bad, but it's still not...
Okay, like...
You know, great. It's still a little messy.
I had a long day yesterday. I went to sleep, and then I got up for work.
Yeah. I'm surprisingly clean. Like, my room is freaking clean. I've just... Once you get used to, like, I have a place for everything, and I know where it goes, and once I get used to it, like, I just put it there,
you know. Yeah.
I don't know, but I'm a little OCD, so that factors into it as well.
Right.
That's it. Check out my Twitch channel. I will be streaming all week, Destiny, all the time. Maybe I want to do like one day a week where I stream something different, but that hasn't happened yet because Destiny.
Yeah, dude. Because you need to finish BioShock.
This is true. Also,
you're almost to the part you probably like forget the whole beginning, so now the ending's gonna be horrible.
No, nah, I remember most of it, but the next Tuesday, we'll have a podcast before then. But just
a reminder,
next Tuesday when Eric gets the game, I'm also trying to convince a friend to iJenner to pick up the game as well.
Really?
Awesome. Yeah, I'm trying to convince.
Really, you're gonna convince a PC gamer to buy an MMO?
He's not a PC gamer. He doesn't play MMOs. He was like Skyrim.
I guess
Minecraft.
He only plays Black Ops.
He plays Black Ops
PC.
On PC, yeah, because it's easy to stream.
Yeah, that's true.
So I'm trying to convince him. If we can have that, where if we can just, it probably wouldn't be that Tuesday because Destiny reset. But maybe on Wednesday, we'll just have a late night stream where we play, or maybe late night on Tuesday, we'll just play a bunch of Elder Scrolls, leveling, just hanging out, being chill. It'll be fun. It'll be fun. Maybe we'll get to the end game of that one day. Maybe. Most likely not, but maybe. So yeah, that is it. You've seen Eric's random item. And I don't have any. I don't have one for today. So, Chick-fil-A cup, stay fresh. And we'll see you next
stay
week.
Stay fresh. And do it!
Just do it! Yesterday you said tomorrow. Make your dreams come true.